Well, there certainly is a lot of buzz surrounding LED masks for various skin concerns, whether it be acne, wrinkles, anti-aging, skin redness. In today's video, I'm going to share with you what we know about LED face masks, how they work, and importantly, I'm going to be talking about how to choose one because there are so many out there with all sorts of claims, bells and whistles, and a wide, wide variety of price points. So what should you look for? Are these even worth your time? What is LED therapy? How does it work? LED therapy works by photobiomodulation, meaning specific wavelengths of light stimulate cellular activity. This results in boosting of collagen, reducing inflammation, and targeting the acne-causing bacteria, Cutibacterium acnes. What wavelengths of light? Blue light at 415 nanometers specifically targets the acne-causing bacterium, Cutibacterium acnes. Red light, ranging anywhere from 630 to 660 nanometers, is known to reduce inflammation, promote healing, improve cellular metabolism, and stimulate collagen production. And the combination of red and blue light have been shown to be beneficial for the treatment of acne specifically. Near infrared light, on the other hand, which spans the wavelengths 830 to 850 nanometers roughly, allows for deeper penetration into the skin to support skin rejuvenation, healing, and collagen production. So for the purposes of rejuvenation, improving the appearance of aging skin, improving collagen production, ultimately reducing wrinkles, red and near infrared wavelengths of light can definitely be beneficial. So what really matters when it comes to choosing an LED mask? First of all, the wavelength. You want to stick to evidence-based wavelengths of light that do what it is that you are looking to get out of the device. When it comes to acne, choose a mask that has blue light, which is going to be roughly 415 nanometers in wavelength. Remember, this is the wavelength that targets the acne-causing bacterium, Cutibacterium acnes. But also, look for acne masks that, in addition to having blue light, also have red light. Red light ranges from roughly 630 to 660 nanometers in wavelength. Red light has been shown to be helpful for reducing redness, for reducing the inflammation of acne, and ultimately may be beneficial in scarring. And studies that we have on these LED masks and LED therapy for acne show that the combination of blue and red light together lead to better outcomes in acne than either color alone. So better than a blue light mask alone or better than a red light mask alone. Now, when it comes to photo rejuvenation, anti-aging, improving wrinkles, sun damage, you want to look for the combination of red and near infrared. So as a reminder, red is 630 to 660, give or take, nanometers, whereas near infrared is anywhere from 830 to roughly 850 nanometers. If you don't have acne, there's really no need to pursue blue light. Look for a device that clearly states the wavelengths of light used in the device. Now, you'll come across a lot of other LED devices out there that have a couple of other bells and whistles, different colors of light, like purple, green, yellow. And while you'll come across some studies on those other colors of light in devices, they're not as well researched, they're not as evidence-based, and for the most part, I find that those different colors of light kind of dilute out the real solid evidence-based red, near-infrared, or blue in the case of acne, light bulbs, and so basically you're getting kind of a suboptimal mask, in my opinion, in most cases when you have all of these different colors. And again, a lot of that will depend on the nuances of the particular mask. There are so many out there that I wouldn't say it necessarily is a make or break if the mask offers an additional color of light that's not the most research-backed. It's kind of all in how it is being dosed, how it is being provided, and a lot of devices incorporate technologies that are not well evidence-based into the LED device. For example, they'll use high frequency or that electroporation, and it's just kind of like, what all is going on in this device? All that other energy going into the device largely is, I think, just for show. Safety is a big thing here. There are a lot of devices out there, so I always suggest looking for a device that is FDA cleared. And no, FDA cleared is not the same as FDA approved, but FDA cleared does offer some additional reassurance of safety and efficacy standards. And you can look for some other things along with that, like 510K designation, CE mark, and ROHS. I also recommend looking for masks that have a flexible silicone backing to allow for comfortable wear and close proximity to the skin, because having the bulbs close to the skin allows for really effective delivery of the light into the skin. The greater the distance the light has to travel from the bulb to your skin, the less effective it can be depending on how the device is constructed, how it's powered and everything. So that's definitely something to take into account. A lot of people will see a device like a panel and think it's much better because the bulbs are a lot stronger, but the bulbs have to be stronger because they are at a distance. In my opinion, it's better to use a mask that is close to the skin, that has a good number of bulbs evenly spaced throughout the mask for good coverage. The more bulbs, the better the depth of penetration and the better the coverage. I suggest looking for masks that have adjustable straps so that you can better accommodate the mask to your individual face shape. Other safety features that I think are really important are an auto shutoff mechanism so that you don't end up using the mask for too long. Also, specifically when it comes to blue light can actually be damaging to your eyes. And so you want to look for a device that has some safety mechanism built in place to protect the eyes. So now that you know some of the features to look for in a mask, what are the downsides of using these masks? Well, the common adverse events that people might encounter are temporary skin irritation and dryness. Again, the concern around eye damage is with blue light. So you always want to make sure that not only are you using a mask that has been vetted for safety, that has mechanisms in place that protect the eyes, but also you want to make sure you're following the directions very carefully and that you're only using the mask as directed. A lot of times, for example, I get questions about, can I take my face mask and put it on my head or put it on my neck, put it on my chest? And while I see a lot of people doing that, I think if you're using a blue light mask, that offers more of a potential for you to damage your eyes using it incorrectly or not as advised. So just be really careful. You'll recall back in 2019, Neutrogena had a really good acne face mask and they just took it off the market out of theoretical concern for eye safety about the blue light. Their masks never actually harmed anyone's eyes, but they removed it from the market due to concerns about that. And the mask that I recommend has built-in protection. Okay, but here's something specifically I want to address when it comes to the masks, and that is I get a lot of questions, are these safe for people with melasma? And that's a really good question. So we don't really have any research for or against the use of at-home LED masks for melasma. Like, is it beneficial? Is it harmful? Does it do nothing? There are a lot of valid concerns, however, with regards to the use of at-home LED masks for melasma, which I will highlight in a moment. I will say that red light LED therapy has actually been shown to be helpful for melasma. When it comes to masks, however, you want to seriously consider against blue light masks for melasma because blue light has been shown actually to trigger melasma. The other concern with these masks and potentially aggravating melasma, people verbalize they're worried that they do emit near-infrared light, some of them do, the anti-aging ones, and that could generate heat. Yes, infrared radiation is associated with heat, but in the case of these masks, it's not generating much heat at all. In order to aggravate melasma, and no mask should be heating the skin to that extent. If you have a mask that heats the skin to that extent, I'd be worried that that mask is just not very good. Well-crafted masks that have the appropriate wavelengths of light and are dosed correctly and safely, they shouldn't be heating the skin like this. Now, I want to also make it clear that these masks should not and do not emit ultraviolet radiation. That's the bad radiation that comes from the sun and worsens all sorts of skin problems. The other concern with melasma and these masks is simply there is a possibility for skin irritation. Irritation is one of the more common side effects that people experience, albeit it's usually temporary, but with melasma, it's such a fickle skin condition that irritation can aggravate it. I also caution that when it comes to the irritation piece, a lot of people may be putting themselves at greater risk for irritation by applying skincare products and then putting the mask on immediately over it because the mask serves as a type of occlusive therapy and products under occlusion, it does increase the risk for irritation from those products. So that's kind of another factor. But if you go online on various forums, you're gonna find people verbalizing all different types of experiences with these masks for their melasma. Some people say that the masks helped. Some people say that the masks made it worse. So anecdotes can be beneficial when we don't have any good evidence, but they are just that, anecdotes. So at the end of the day, I think it's prudent to avoid LED masks if you have melasma. I would strongly discourage using masks that have blue light because that is known to aggravate melasma. melasma. And if you have acne, you know, blue light is what you would want. But if you have acne and melasma, I would reconsider the use of the mask in that case, because there are other acne treatments out there. What can you expect from these types of masks? First and foremost, the masks only work if you use them consistently. The frequency with which you use the mask will just depend on the individual mask. So usually it's anywhere from 2 to 3 times a week, sometimes daily, depending on the mask. But don't use it more frequently than what is suggested, as that might increase the likelihood of irritation and problems. They're not a magic bullet by any means, but they definitely can help, and they do have solid research behind them. Red and near infrared, solid research for improving not only wrinkles, but also can improve just overall skin hydration, calm down irritation, inflammation, improve skin clarity, skin tone. And yeah, there are even studies showing that these wavelengths of light can be beneficial for melasma. Also, the red and blue light can definitely be very helpful for acne. There are even some studies suggesting that the LED masks for acne can be as effective as benzoyl peroxide, a really well-established acne treatment for mild to moderate acne. Now, if you have moderate to severe acne, are these masks going to clear it up? No. Set your expectations to be realistic. Even if you have mild to moderate acne, you likely may still need additional topicals. I think really where these masks for acne, specifically the red and blue light masks for acne, really can make a huge difference in those motivated to use them consistently, because again, they only work if you use them. As if you're someone who has gotten to near clear status of your mild to moderate acne with topical medications, like you're doing really well with a topical regimen, and you're kind of at that point where you're not 100% clear, but you personally, you're not so keen on maybe certain oral medications, it might be worth considering in that case. Talk to your doctor, of course, if that would be right for you. But in a lot of cases, it's definitely a helpful supplement to topical medications. Sometimes it might even be potentially as good as a single agent for some people with very mild acne. So I think it's worth considering in that regard. It's also safe to use during pregnancy. So a lot of, you know, oral medications at least are not acne, are not pregnancy safe. And so this might be an additional thing during pregnancy that you might find helpful. That being said, a lot of women do experience melasma during pregnancy. So it is a delicate balance between acne and melasma in pregnancy. So what masks do I recommend? Disclosure, I am affiliated with the company Omnilux, and those are the masks that I recommend. I use them myself. I use the contour. I've tried out the acne mask, which I'll talk about. I don't really have acne, so I use the contour mask, which is red and near infrared. The reason I like Omnilux as a company and their mask is that A, I use them and they work. B, they are the company behind the in-office devices, which have a good track record of efficacy. Obviously, that's what we use in office. C, they're vigorously vetted for safety, which is really important. In the case of the Omnilux clear mask for acne, it has the eye shields built in to protect your eyes from the blue light. I love the flexible design, good contact, good number of bulbs, the bulbs of the appropriate wavelength, not any other gimmicks in there. I prefer masks to handheld devices for ease of use and better contact with the skin. They are a bit of a time commitment, which, you know, sometimes for me is actually a hurdle, because sometimes I just like don't feel like doing it. But when I get in the routine of doing it, and I've been really good about doing it in the past, I would say a year or so, and I definitely see a visible improvement. But if you're someone who's like really rushed, you don't have a lot of time in your day, the idea of sitting there with the mask on, you can multitask with these on, which is another thing I like about them. Like you can load the dishwasher or whatever, but it can be a little hard to like, you can't like read a book. A lot of people like to just lay down in bed and put them on, wear them before they go to sleep at night. And that's really relaxing. They are kind of relaxing to do. So, you know, it's kind of up to you how you see them fitting into your routine, but that's key. If you can't make them part of your routine, then I would say don't invest in them. If you think they might be right for you, talk to your doctor about them, because they are really, really good devices. And, you know, I am affiliated with them, but I was a customer of theirs before I was affiliated with them. They are really, really good masks. Let me know in the comments comments what you think about these masks. Have you tried an LED face mask? How did it go for you? Is it something you're considering? I really hope this video breaking them down helped clarify some things for you guys moving forward. If you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.